Hi everyone, welcome to CareerView's interview series. I am Nancy. I'm a Dubai expatriate from 15 years with over 12 years of experience as a recruitment consultant. I'm the founder of CareerViews.com. I have been working as a corporate HR consultant, career guidance expert, and a blogger. In this video today, I'm going to talk about interview questions for HR executive role and how to answer them. So be ready with your notepad and pen or whatever you may need to take these tips. So before we start the video, if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please do subscribe to it and press the bell icon so that you don't miss any of the career tips. As any other job interview, this one also starts with "Tell me about yourself." Here the interviewers are really intimidating the candidate to tell them what he has accomplished so far in the career. You should make sure that you don't include much of a personal information while answering this question. My main tip would be, do not mention any experiences that are not relevant to the current job profile. There are two potential answers for this question. The first answer would be for the less experienced candidates. So you should start with your name, your university degrees. Do not miss to mention your specialization and the year you have completed your university degree. Your first job for which you have been hired. You can mention that how long you've been working with the company and what you have learned in your current role. Also, you can mention how your qualifications really support the current role. If you've already been experienced, the second potential answer: begin with a brief introduction about your university degree and qualifications, and it should focus more on the job roles you are currently handling. You must not miss to mention that what you are involved in your current job profile and how you could contribute to the new job description. This would give you an opportunity to understand and evaluate how you are a suitable candidate for this role. If your answer to "Tell me about yourself" has been really brief, the interviewers might dig in deep by asking you, what is your background and experience in HR? This question is generally for the experienced candidates who have already been working into the field of human resources. It could be that they want to know more about your professional profile. It could be that they are trying to relate how you are a perfect candidate for this role. This question essentially means that you have to speak about your skills and qualities in detail. It is a very good opportunity for you to score better points by having a crisp answer that makes you feel very, very confident. In the first potential answer to this question, you can always highlight if you don't have any work experience. You can always mention what you have done during your university in the field of human resources. It could be some surveys, it could be some special projects that you've managed with your friends or individually. If you have worked with an organization but at a very initial level, you could always say what kind of things you've been participated in. HR is a wide term. It has so many job responsibilities. There are different departments for different HR functions. So what has been your primary function when it comes to HR? Or if you have just graduated, do not miss to mention what have been your major subjects while undergraduation or post-graduation. The second potential answer is if you are already experienced into HR. You can very clearly mention what job responsibilities you have been managing in your current job role. Do mention 3 to 4 important responsibilities that are a part of the job description for which you have been interviewed for. This way, interviewers could relate how you are a better fit for this role. If you have already been doing the similar tasks, you have high chances of getting hired with this organization. Now let's move on to the third and an important question that no interview goes without. Why we should hire you as HR executive or HR assistant? While answering this, you have to be true about your reasons why you want to join this company and why you should be hired for the roles and not others. So you should be very clear in what you're bringing to the table, what you could do that others cannot, what roles or value addition that you have that others do not. Be very specific about the professional qualities that you possess and answer about it confidently so that interviewers must believe what you are telling is true. The next interview question may sound a cliche, but trust me, it is an important one. The interviewer really wants to see what you're good at. It's your time to shine. The interviewers are looking for your strengths, your capabilities to do the job well. So if you are eager to learn and you pay a little bit attention to detail, you could ace this question. The first potential answer to this question is your chance to serve yourself in a well-decorated plate to the interviewers. And if they get impressed, you have high chances of being considered for the role. You can start with all the qualities that you have, personally and professionally. You can always say it like that. I'm passionate towards my work and also a good listener, which makes me take my instructions seriously. At the entry level or executive level roles, the people who listen carefully and pay attention to detail are always preferred. You never leave your tasks unattended. How proactive you are in meeting the timelines. You can always mention what skills and abilities you have that make you stand apart as a candidate. So focus on individual qualities and construct your answer carefully. The second potential way to show your strength is making your qualities match with the job description. Here, a candidate could see what is really required for the role and convert that into your strengths. So you could always relate your current role to the future role which you have been interviewed for. You can always say, in my current role, I'm responsible for similar duties and responsibilities as mentioned in the job description. This would give you a chance to throw an open-ended question to the recruiters or the hiring managers by asking them what is the most important part of the job description. This way you could learn more and you could enhance your strengths which are related to this role. It's always night after day and day after night. So when it comes to the question about strength, the next potential question is tell us about your weaknesses. We have to understand that by this question, the interviewers are not looking to dig deep into your weaknesses or to insult you, but they are trying to understand how you overcome your weaknesses. We all have them. So while answering this question, you have to make sure that you are aware of your weaknesses and what you are actually doing to overcome them. How self-aware you are about your abilities and what steps you are taking on a daily basis to improve yourself. Never try to answer this question by saying, I don't have any weaknesses. We all have them. And the hiring managers with their experience could see through a candidate. While you prepare the answer and examples for your weaknesses, make sure it's not related to anything which is being asked in the current job role. So make sure you read the job description thoroughly, and none of the weaknesses should be around or related to the role which you've been interviewed for. Let me show you how you can answer this question and come out clean. Ultimately, this is the most popular interview question which many candidates struggle to figure out. So while answering this, you could always say that I'm working on improving something that is related to your personal or professional life. For example, you can mention that I'm always working on improving my communication skills to be more effective presenter. I recently joined a group of HR professionals to share presentations on different topics, which I find very helpful. This would show that you are interested in learning more about human resources and at the same time you're working on your communication skills. It's like shooting two birds with the same arrow. So let's now move on to our next potential answer. This time you could take it a bit personal. You could highlight some weakness which is related to your personal life and how you're trying to overcome it. It shows more humane side of you, and also we all have a personal life to take care of. You can always mention, I work too hard sometimes and I care too much about my work. I take my tasks back home and work whenever I get time or during the weekends. This makes you a workaholic, But your family always point out this is not right. There is an alternate way to improve this issue by working smartly. So I am working with my colleagues or my superiors to how to work around this. And they are helping me. This shows teamwork, trust in your team, and equally giving importance to work-life balance, which is an essential quality that HR must foster. There is always a part of our work that we like or we dislike. So the next question is to understand, do you really enjoy what you do in human resources? This question is, what do you like least about the world of human resources? Ultimately, the interviewer is trying to understand, what do you dislike about your job? While answering this question, make sure you are not neglecting an essential responsibility for this role. For example, if a candidate says, recruiting isn't my passion, but it is a very important aspect of the job description or the role which is being offered as an HR executive. So it doesn't look nice to dislike the important aspect of the job description. So one must be very cautious while answering this tricky question. The potential answer about this question of what you least like about HR should be either department specific or HR's role in general. For example, an HR employee could always mention that HR is not trusted by the employees because they are not having the equal amount of authority as they have the responsibilities. Another good way to answer this question is by making it task specific. For example, some of the employees find HR to be too much of administrative, where HR's role is evolving in day-to-day life. HR spends more time to perform tasks such as documenting problems, employee records, and maintaining the documents and files for other employees, which prevents HR from upgrading its role as a strategic partner in many organizations. This is a generic answer highlighting what could be normally disliked by HR without making you a black sheep while working as an HR employee. Conflict resolution is an integral part of HR. So that's what brings us to our next question, which is, did you ever had a conflict at your workplace? They want you to be genuine with your answer, so they may ask you for an example. So be ready. Whatever answer you prepare, you back it up by giving an example. This is a generic answer for an employee who works with multiple departments. So the answer goes like, I was managing the creation of our onboarding presentation. My team had to meet a very tight deadline because everything had to be delivered on time for the new hires. I was in charge for the deliverables and had to coordinate between different departments, which included marketing, graphic design, and senior leaders. Our graphic designer was very talented, but he unfortunately missed a deadline. When I approached him under pressure, under the heat of argument, he started being abusive, and I was taken aback, but I explained my reasoning again. Eventually, I spoke to my manager for a solution and we raised a complaint. An AVP dismissed the graphic designer for some time. Ultimately, the responsibility came on our shoulders and we finished the presentation and delivered it successfully. This showed the reason of conflict, how you managed it, what steps you have taken, and ultimately what was the result of conflict management. So you may give this example as it is. For hiring managers, it's very important to understand the overall personality of HR professionals. HR is said to be the backbone of any organization. So it's very important to ask an employee, what do your friends or co-workers say about you or think about you? The answer to this question goes like, since I like to build strong professional relationships with my teammates, most of them have become great friends. Once my project lead told me that at a completion of an HR project, she knew that she could count on me. This showed the candidate as a trusted employee. So I would definitely say that you mention something professional or give an example of a compliment that you have received during your career. It's good for hiring managers to understand the employee expectations of an ideal workplace. It is a good question for HR professionals to be asked that what is their definition of an ideal company or a workplace. So the answer goes like, my ideal company is the one which can bring forth exciting challenges. Such opportunities will bring out the best in me. This would definitely highlight that you want to learn more, you want to upskill yourself or grow as a professional. Also, do not miss to highlight what do you enjoy the most in your present workplace and what you are looking forward to learn if given an opportunity to join this organization. You could give an example by going through company's vision, mission or values, how you could integrate that in your professional liking for the company. If the interviewers are keen to understand your salary expectations, this means you are halfway there. When the hiring managers ask you this question, what are your salary expectations? There are certain tips from my side how you should answer it. When you are doing the preparations for the interview, it's always good to have this question in your mind. Have a look of the salaries which are being offered in the similar industry, similar area, or to the people who possess similar qualifications like you. This way you could get an idea, or it would be nice to talk to any of your ex-colleagues or anybody whom you know who has been working in the similar field. Always be ready with the salary range. Never put a figure in mind that I want to achieve this in my professional career. Giving them a broad salary range would make your prospects higher. So let me show you some of the answers that you could mention while answering this. As I said earlier, always mention a broader range when it comes to your salary expectations. You could quote a range from whatever figure is in your mind and until what is the final figure that you would be ready to take. It's good that you're mentioning that figure annually, monthly, whatever your expectations are. To show confidence, you can always say, I believe my salary expectations are very much in line with the current industry standards and are according to my experience and qualifications. But I am open for further discussions, because you never know what are the other perks associated with the position. So be always open for negotiations. If by any chance you have not got the opportunity to do your homework for the salary research, or you have been introduced by a recruiter or a third party, you could answer this question in this way. Thank you, ma'am, sir. Once my responsibilities are clear, I can state an exact figure. Right now, I would like to know what my potential manager expects from this job position in your organization. After this discussion, maybe we can both meet a conclusion about my future remuneration. This way, you could show that sometimes having a better job role or better responsibilities is more important than having a higher salary. This would show you as a genuine candidate and would bring your prospects as more stronger than the other candidates who are only after money. When you come towards the end of an interview, interviewers generally ask a candidate, do you have any questions for us? So the tip to answer this is never say no. It is perhaps the worst response ever given by any candidate. Remember that interviewers are not integrations or business conversations. It gives you an opportunity to know as much as you want about the organization, about the job role. Every candidate must prepare in advance for some interview questions that they want to ask to the interviewers or the hiring managers. I'm going to show you a short video about the questions that a candidate can ask the hiring managers or the interviewers. I hope you found this video useful. I will be making more videos about interview sessions for different positions. So stay tuned to Career Views. If you've not subscribed to my channel, do subscribe it. This video would be in my playlist for interview preparation. There are a lot many questions and answers related to interviews in that playlist. If you'd like, you can visit my channel anytime and review that playlist for any kind of interview preparation. Do let me know in the comments, how are you finding my videos? How did you like this particular video? Any other topics or any other position that you want me to make videos about? I'll be very happy to understand that from you, and I'll surely try to make those videos. Until next time, stay tuned to Career Views. Keep liking, sharing my videos with your network. Do comment, how did you found the video? I would be very happy to know what kind of responses my video gets. Stay tuned to Career Views. Thank you for watching.